What is wanted from an artist is he invents new things and not to confirm what has already been done by others in the past. The contrary, he must do something new.
So Jean Dubuffet was one of the most important artists to appear in Europe after World War II. He was born in 1901 in Le Havre in Normandy. He moved in 1918 to Paris to study art. But it's only after several failed attempts to become an artist that he really settled in Paris in 1942 and started to work relentlessly, producing some 10,000 works over a 40-year period.
Dubuffet en het Stedelijk Museum hebben een bijzondere relatie. Al eind jaren 50 ging Sandberg twee werken aanschaffen voor de collectie van het Stedelijk bij Dubuffet. Geïnspireerd eigenlijk door de liefde die de Cobra-kunstenaars hadden voor deze kunstenaar. En Edith de Wilde in 1963 nam het stokje over met heel veel kracht. Dus die schreef meteen een brief naar Dubuffet: ik wil met jou een tentoonstelling maken. En daar werden aankopen verricht en Dubuffet besloot op een gegeven moment om heel veel werken te geven aan het Stedelijk Museum. En dat betekent dus dat we een enorm corpus aan werken hebben.
So it's hard to describe his work in general because he produced work in lots of different mediums, lots of different formats. He used often very classical subject matters. You have nudes, you have still lifes, you have landscapes. But he used a lot of non-artistic materials over the years. So technically he was a very interesting and varied artist. What there is to see in the exhibition is basically two stories that I'm telling. One story is simply the works that the Stedelijk Museum acquired from Dubuffet. There's 16 paintings, one sculpture, several series of lithographs, which are dated from the 1940s to the 70s. And they span two directors, Willem Sandberg and Eddy de Wilde. And the other story, which I call Dubuffet the Deep End, is a story of how Dubuffet in his work tries to disorientate viewers. First, in the 40s and 50s, by making people look downwards. He makes you focus on things that people don't normally notice. You know, the sand on the ground, the little pebbles, things like that. So he makes you focus on that, which means that then when you look back at the world, your vision is transformed. He worked with the principle of assemblage. So at some point in his life, he used butterfly wings. At another point, he gathered leaves on the ground and he made paintings which he called botanical elements, which are made of pieces of nature, of moss, of grass, found on the ground and put together in a painting.
Kleine hoefblad en blad wijnstok. In ieder geval, dat zijn de bladeren die geïdentificeerd zijn. Wat we hier zien zijn twee werken, eigenlijk twee collages van Dubuffet. Het zijn twee werken gemaakt met bladeren. De ene heet Verfront en de andere is Automne en zijn beide in 1959 gemaakt. Deze werken zien er heel kwetsbaar uit, zeker als je ze onder microscoop kijkt. En mij werd gevraagd om te onderzoeken of deze werken überhaupt konden reizen. En ik ben begonnen om deze werken te bekijken en expertise in te winnen in 2013. En ik ben bij de Kew Gardens in Londen terechtgekomen. Wij hebben de oude fotodocumentatie die aanwezig is in het museum gebruikt. En die hebben vergeleken met de huidige toestand van het werk. En aan de hand van die vergelijking hebben we kunnen zien dat er eigenlijk bijna of heel gering bladverlies is geweest. En dat eigenlijk de werken vrij stabiel zijn.
So in the works from the 60s and the 70s, one thing that's interesting is that you see different paintings and sculptures and also some multiples from the series called Lourloupe. Is the cycle that occupies Dubuffet for about 10 years, from 1962 to 1973-74. And the origin of the Ourloupe is that he was on the telephone one day and he started doodling on a notepad. He then realized that when you put them on a contrasting background, suddenly created little figures that were very much alive. So he developed little drawings like this, and then these drawings became paintings, and suddenly the whole world was transformed by him into this visual vocabulary. After making paintings, he discovered this material called styrofoam, and he realized that he could carve out of blocks of styrofoam and make sculptures connected to these paintings of the Oorloop. And that was the starting point for not only smaller sculptures, but also monumental works, even little architectures in which you could walk around.
Het bijzondere aan deze tentoonstelling, The Deep End in het Stedelijk Museum, met werken van Dubuffet uit de collectie van het Stedelijk Museum, is dat er een parallelle tentoonstelling van het werk van Dubuffet plaatsvindt in het Rijksmuseum, waarin de grote sculpturen die hij heeft gemaakt in de tuinen zijn geplaatst.
You know, I think of these sculptures as really objects that completely disorientate your perception. Suddenly your world is no longer made of horizontal and vertical lines that divide space, but they're this kind of swirling, anarchic lines, and the idea is that you see the world a little bit differently. Dubuffet was in fact somebody who really thought about what he was doing. He was highly reflexive because he was a theorist as well as being an artist. He wrote books about culture, he gave lectures, he wrote about his own practice. So you have to imagine that Dubuffet was around at the time of Surrealism in the 20s in France. He knew everyone, he circulated in different artistic circles, he saw what was being done, but he didn't fit in, he didn't want to make art in the style of Cubism or Surrealism. He needed something like 20 years in order to find the kind of art he could make that for him made him enter in art, but being an outsider.
Yeah. I want to have a position, a similar position as the insane have. That is to say, to ignore the culture and to ignore the normal, to make something non-normal. I think that is what is wanted from an artist, to make something non-normal, exceptional.
People should see the exhibition because it's not a huge exhibition, so people can really take their time to look at different works and really bathe in this atmosphere of Dubuffet's work, just maybe become more sensitive to the way in which they walk, the way in which they look at things around them. That is something that I'd be happy for people to take with them.